how to make a transfer printing.
Create a design on paper.
Flip design to put it on reverse.
Go over your design in transfer paint.
Now get the design and place on synthetic fabric.
Now make sure your synthetic fabric shiny side is up.
Now iron your design, putting even pressure throughout.
Hello everyone, welcome to Have Live. I am currently speaking with Andy Devine, my mentor who works for a media company named MEC Global, and we have been given this wonderful opportunity, seeming as we are a media and enterprise academy, to interview Andy Devine. So Andy, what is media to you? Is it advertising, marketing? Give us your own definition for media.
Hi Bintu, good morning to you. I think it's all of those things. So it includes advertising, but in terms of what the company does that I work for is media planning and buying. It's
Hello, my name is Umu Howell.
And my name's Kaneda.
Hello and welcome to
the Student Services Advice Show.
Today we'll be talking about tips on crossing the roads.
As you all know, crossing the road is a very important thing you need to be careful about.
First tip, always look left and right before you cross.
Always listen out in case you can't see the cars that are coming towards you.
Don't talk on the phone while crossing the roads, as it could distract you.
Always wait for the green man before you cross.
So, we are done with the tips.
Now for the quiz. Here are some questions on last week's advice about cyberbullying.
Don't forget to put your name, age and mentoring group, then give it to your mentor.
Question 1. Who should you call if you want to discuss your feelings and problems with someone?
Question 2. Who should you call if the bullying gets serious?
Question 3. What was last week's advice about?
Question 4. If the bully keeps disturbing you, what do you do?
Question 5. What do you do to relax?
Thank you for listening.
And tune in next week for more. And remember, be safe on the roads.
Bye.
Here I am in Harris Academy Bermondsey's playground, and I can see the Shard in the distance.
We're walking along Towerbridge Road and we've just seen our first real glimpse of the Shard. We're all very excited and our steps are becoming much faster. We've just turned onto Thomas Street where we could see our first proper view of the Shard. It looks spectacular.
It's really tall and I'm excited, but it looks really high. That's all I can say.
I can barely walk up to the first floor in science.
I like the glass around it.
It's kind of pointy and stuff.
Harris Academy Bermondsey presents part 5 of a new radio adaptation of William Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet. In her last episode, Romeo slayed Tybalt in an act of revenge and is now on the run. Today's episode opens with Juliet visiting Friar Lawrence for help, only to find Paris there, the man her parents want her to marry. The friar dismisses Paris and offers to help Juliet by giving her a drug that will put her in a death-like coma. He promises to send a message to inform Romeo of the plan so that he can rejoin her when she awakens.
Now, do you know the reason of this haste?
I would. I knew not why it should be slow. Oh, look, sir. Here comes the lady towards my cell.
Happily met, my lady. My wife.
That may be, sir, when I may be a wife.
That may be, must be on Thursday next.
What must be, shall be.
That's a certain text.
Come to make confession to thy father.
To answer that, I should confess to you. Are you at holy leisure, father, now?
My leisure serves me pensive daughter now. My lord, we must entreat this time alone.
Juliet, on Thursday next will I rouse you. To then, adieu, and keep this holy kiss.
Oh, shut the door. God join my heart, thou Romeo's. Give me some prison counsel. I long to die. And if thou speak, speak not of a remedy.
I do spy a kind of hope. If rather than to marry, come to Paris.
Refresh yourself. Deception, immorality, corruption. Do you know what it is? Do you? It's there when you're having your McDonald's. It's there with your KFC. It is the unthinkable, the undrinkable Coca-Cola. Now I know what you're thinking. Refreshing, replenishing, revitalizing. That thirst-quenching feeling, that fizz bubbling in your mouths, that exotic taste of a summer's day. But do you know the mystery behind that tantalizing taste? Do you know the journey it takes for the sugars to get to our drinks? Do you know of those vulnerable, innocent children bleeding endlessly from machetes and oven knives that they are being forced to use to harvest the sugars that you so greedily indulge in your drinks? Defeated, despondent, sick and wishing, pleading, begging to survive. Inside their body, ache is at war. Is there no end to this constant pain? It is a fact. Up to 30,000 Salvadorian children, most as young as 8, are being forced into hazardous child labour by Coca-Cola. Now, do you think that this is right? Do you think that these children, these voices of tomorrow, should be trapped in a world of injustice while we are here satisfying our thirsts? Along with that comes Coca-Cola's abuse on the environment. In this light of controversy, in a small town in India where water supply is increasingly low, Coca-Cola stole 1.5 million litres of water, which they then bottled and sold. Water that many villagers and many farmers rely on as it is the only source of water that they have. Practically bleeding their wells dry, this resulted in the remaining waters becoming contaminated. 1.5 million litres. Can you imagine how many people you could help with this supply of water? You can improve agriculture, quality of life, healthcare. What can 1.5 million litres of water do? Ask yourselves. So that gets us thinking, why? Why would Coca-Cola want to steal this amount of water? The answer, ladies and gentlemen, is us. To give us that thirst-quenching feeling, that fizz bubbling in your mouths. And what is the mystery behind that tantalizing taste? Deception, immorality, corruption. Now I'm not here to ban Coca-Cola, who know my friends. In fact, Coca-Cola is refreshing, it's just great. But down the road and around the corner, there is another world to be found. So as a result of this, I ask of you tonight to go out and tell your brothers, your sisters, your cousins, and your neighbors not to buy Coca-Cola until their deceitful actions are abolished. Because our desires build up many people's hardships.
Hello, and welcome to
0011.
I'm Aleph.
And I'm Dina.
Today we're going to be talking about time travel.
Time travel. So, Alfie, is time travel actually possible?
Well, that's the big question these days, but most scientists think probably not. It's kind of complicated. But if you imagine, when you're walking, you're travelling through space. And if you're travelling through time, well, you're not travelling through space, you're travelling through time.